4 seconds left, Super Bowl 25. Scott Norwood's 47-yard field goal attempt to win it for Buffalo sails wide, and New York has the victory. The second Super Bowl triumph for coach Bill Parcells in his last game as Giants coach. Now, 2 seasons later, Parcells returns to the field, beginning a new era as coach of the New England Patriots, ironically facing the team he beat in his last game, the Buffalo Bills. 80,000 fans are set out at Rich Stadium, the fans still thirsting for revenge for that one-point Super Bowl loss as the New England Patriots take on the Buffalo Bills. Hello, everyone, and welcome to Rich Stadium for this season opener. Tom Hammond and Chris Collinsworth. The Patriots have undergone a complete renovation almost. New uniforms, a new coach, and a new quarterback that's drawing raves.
Yeah, we talked to Bill Parcells yesterday, and he seemed about as relaxed and happy as I have ever seen him. I think a big reason for that, the play of Drew Bledsoe. He made a statement I found hard to believe, that Drew Bledsoe had the best arm of any quarterback he has ever seen. That strong.
Buffalo has the core of its AFC championship team together, but the whole world rooting against a fourth trip to the Super Bowl.
Yeah, we talked to Jim Kelly and Andre Reed yesterday as well, and they said that their lone goal for 1993 was to tick off the entire United States of America and make it back to a fourth Super Bowl.
Buffalo to kick off. Christie approaches the ball, and New England with Brown and Crittenden deep, and that one will sail out of the end zone. So the New England Patriots will take over at their 20-yard line with Drew Bledsoe, first player taken in the draft, set for his first NFL snap. A great preseason for the rookie from Washington State.
And these fans are going to try to make it as uncomfortable a debut as they possibly can.
Bill Parcells researched it thoroughly. He has all the faith in the world in Bledsoe. And what must be going through the rookie's mind? His first pro snap. It's a handoff to Russell, Leonard Russell, number one rusher in the preseason for the Patriots. And an injury-plagued 92 season. Parcells playing it safe, calling a run on Bledsoe's first play.
Just want to give the rookie a chance to get his feet underneath him. A little bit relaxed. Maybe now he'll start breathing in the huddle.
Do you remember your first play?
Oh, I can remember it well. I dropped the very first pass I've thrown ever.
First pass for Bledsoe. And way off target, intended for Russell out of the backfield.
It appeared to be an option route that time by Leonard Russell. He chose to hook in rather than breaking out, simply a misread. Drew Bledsoe is a young man that really had an amazing college career. Second all-time at Washington State. Jack Thompson still holds all the records there. Bledsoe, 500 yards less than Thompson, but he did it in about 15 fewer games.
Nickel defense for the Bills. Darby and Washington into the secondary. Quick release by Bledsoe. Too wide for the intended receiver. Tight end Marv Cook. Phil Hansen coming after Bledsoe. So 0 for 2 on the first series for Drew Bledsoe, and the Patriots must punt.
He looked a little nervous, his feet dancing around in the pocket. Can't really blame a young man after being the number one pick in the entire draft and having to face really a very good defense in the Buffalo Bills.
Mike Saxon to punt for New England with Russell Copeland deep for the Bills. Takes a fortunate New England bounce, but still not a very good kick. Out of bounds at the Buffalo 40-yard line. So Jim Kelly, after that 38-yard punt, will bring his offense onto the field. Kelly with a high number of interceptions for him last season, but 105 touchdown passes the last 4 years. That's tops in the NFL. Also in the backfield, Thurman Thomas, 4 straight years, the NFL's best all-purpose running back. Reed has had some great games against New England. And up front, all eyes on John Fina, who replaces departed free agent Will Wolford. John Davis subs for the injured Kent Hall at center.
Fina told us yesterday that everybody in Buffalo is anxious over how he'll protect Jim Kelly. He said even his mother and sister's been giving him a rough time.
He said anxiety in the community over John Fina at left tackle. Kelly right to the air. Thomas, his first reception of the season. Good for a short gain, out of bounds, shy of midfield. Barnett bumping Thomas out of bounds, and here's the no-huddle offense we expected to see from Kelly and the Bills.
The biggest reason for the no-huddle, according to Tom Bresnahan, the offensive coordinator, is just doesn't give the other team a chance to recognize your formation.
Thurman Thomas picks his way forward, close to a first down, into New England territory to the 45-yard line.
Well, as nervous as Bledsoe looked, the Buffalo Bills appear to be very calm. They are just picking right up where they left off last season, and offensively, this is as good a team as any in the NFL.
Led the AFC in scoring last season. Gardner and Turner, two fullbacks on the field right now for the Bills. Turner had a great training camp. They come with two tight ends as well, Metzelaars and Ewalt. Third and less than a yard. And the give is to Nate Turner, and Turner has the Buffalo first down. Here's the way New England will start defensively, and the strength of that Patriot defense is the linebackers. Tippett, the only remnant of New England's Super Bowl team, has been to five Pro Bowls. Brown, leading tackler the last two seasons. Singleton was a first-round choice. And two secondary starters played for Parcells in New York, Thompson and White. Kelly pumps once, and will scramble. Stop short of the 40-yard line. Jim Kelly says he's in the best shape of his career, and he made some dietary sacrifices to do it.
Nice job here by the secondary from New England. Really no place to throw the football. A bit of a surprise, rather than the traditional Bill Parcells two-deep zone. They went drop back with three people. May have confused Jim Kelly.
He rushed, as you see, 31 times last season. He would eat up to six peanut butter sandwiches a day. He's given up peanut butter and whole milk and red meat as well. Thurman Thomas inside the 35 of the Patriots. Thurman Thomas with a rich new contract, a contract who's been felt all over the NFL. It had impacts on the Emmett Thomas case.
That's exactly right. Emmett Smith would very much
what I say,
like,
Emmett Thomas,
yeah,
Emmett
would
Smith.
Very much like to get Thurman Thomas money.
There's a Freudian slip combining the two there. That's one of the sticking points with Emmett Smith, that Thurman Thomas contract. And Thomas, as expected, the workhorse, pounds ahead for the first down.
Once again, Thurman Thomas doing exactly what he did a year ago. He led the NFL in total yards for a record fourth straight season. That broke Jim Brown's mark of three. He was the MVP in 1991, four-time Pro Bowlers, has led the Bills in rushing all five of his years here.
Kelly looks, pumps twice, finally dumps it off. Dangerous pass as a flag goes down. Andre Reed with a short reception across the middle.
Holding, number 51 of the offense, 10 yards, repeat first down.
Jerry Austin with a call against Jim Richard, veteran guard of the Buffalo Bills, in his 14th season out of North Carolina State, former first-round draft choice, 207 career games, which is number one in Buffalo history.
And he's surrounded this year by two new players, John Davis filling in for the injured Kent Hall at center, and, of course, John Fina replacing Will Wolford, who left via free agency.
Sets up a first and 20 for Buffalo. Ball at the 43 of New England. Opening series for the Bills. Scoreless game.
Kelly is sacked back to the 45-yard line. Great defensive charge by Ray Agnew, the former first-round draft choice out of North Carolina State, came through to get Kelly.
Agnew with perhaps his best season a year ago, and he's picking up right now. Watch the rush. That's just a bull rush. Beautiful job coming in against the guard Glenn Parker, who is the Buffalo Bills' highest paid offensive lineman.
Agnew, the 10th player taken in the 90 draft, with his first sack. Draw play to Thomas, picks his way forward, back into Patriot territory, stopped at about the 48-yard line by Vincent Brown.
You know, that's classic Bill Parcells football. They may give up a few long drives, but then generally defensively they will come up with a big play, just like Ray Agnew did, throwing the Buffalo Bills back into a third and very long.
Nickel package on the field for Parcells Patriots. Third and 24. Well, were they drawn offside? That seems to be the question of the moment for Jerry Austin.
10:09 left in the opening quarter. Beautiful Western New York afternoon.
We have a false start, number 74 on the offense. The defense has been warned. He charges through the line again. Then it'll be a foul on the defense. It's a warning on the first one.
Lower right side of the screen, that's Glenn Parker. And the rule this year is that they're going to let those defensive linemen come charging through like that one time, get a warning. After that, it's going to be a penalty.
Barry Sanders with an early touchdown for the Lions. We're scoreless here in Buffalo. Kelly has time, goes deep. Reed almost made a one-handed grab, but it falls incomplete, and Buffalo will bring the punting team on for the first time in this game as Reed couldn't quite collar it.
Parcells has to be happy with his defense. That looked like was going to be just another Buffalo Bills long drive that we've seen so much of in the past 4 or 5 years, but his defense, Ray Agnew, came up, made the big sack, and they hold on the first series.
Troy Brown deep for the Patriots as Chris Moore will kick it. As you saw, Moore averaging over 42 yards. Pretty good kicking in Buffalo. Fair catch called and taken at the 9-yard line. And New England will have its offense back on the field. We're scoreless after that 44-yard punt. It was hot and heavy.
Well, that makes Bill happy because he can yell a lot then.
Bledsoe backed up at his own 10-yard line. Second possession, he was 0 for 2. First time the Pats had the ball. Russell tries to get to the outside and does bounce out there. Dives forward for a gain of 5 to the 15-yard line.
Marcus Patton took him out of bounds.
Marcus Patton knocking Russell out of bounds as we take a look at the New England lineup. Starting for the Patriots, Leonard Russell, after an injury-plagued second year, hopes to return to rookie form. He gained 900 yards. Gash, who carried just 5 times last season at fullback. Brisby, one of 3 rookie starters on offense. And Cook may be the best receiving tight end in football. Offensive line has 3 first-round choices, Armstrong, Chung, and Harlow. Pound straight ahead to Russell again, and Russell falls across the 20 and has a New England first down, their initial first down of the game. Marcus Patton on the stop, and here's the Buffalo starting defense. Smith and Wright, new lucrative contracts. Bennett back outside. Patton replaces Shane Conlon inside, and Maddox getting his second career start today. In the secondary, Henry Jones tied for the NFL interception lead last season. He had 8. First down, New England from the 21. Again, it's Russell. No, it's Gash, excuse me. Met at the line of scrimmage and thrown back by Bruce Smith.
Bruce Smith told us yesterday that he had a pulled hamstring. It happened in the last preseason game. He hasn't made much of an issue about it so far, but he was jumping up in that game, and one of the Falcons' offensive linemen stuck him in the chest and pulled his hamstring, so he's not 100% today.
If there's any player that has a revenge motive against Bill Parcells, it might be Bruce Smith. He goes back to Super Bowl 25. Bledsoe on a draw, handoff to Russell. Again, a short gain. He's Maddox and Hansen combined, and it's Sam Gash again, excuse me. Well, Bruce Smith, you remember, before Super Bowl 25, said that he was replacing Lawrence Taylor as the dominant defensive player in the NFL. He didn't have such a great Super Bowl, and Parcells came down on him hard after the game was over. And it turns out that Parcells might have been a little more worried about Bruce Smith than everyone thought. Before the Super Bowl, in practice, he told Lawrence Taylor to pick a fight with Jumbo Elliott, the offensive lineman of the Giants, who would be blocking Smith. And Lawrence Taylor wanted to know why, and finally did it anyway, and Parcells said maybe he's worried about Bruce Smith. Bledsoe, with his first completion, takes it to the 30-yard line. Gash grabs it and then is pounced on by Tally and Jones.
Tally and Jones on the stop.
That'll be short of the first down.
You know the defensive lineman from Buffalo would love to be the first one to put Drew Bledsoe on his back. Here it goes, a little quarterback sandwich. And maybe a little conversation after that one.
Hanson and Smith sandwiching Bledsoe after he got rid of the football. Saxon with his second punt. Spent 8 years with the Dallas Cowboys, of course, their all-time punting leader. Didn't have a good one the first time. And this one isn't very good either. Bounces around the 40. Copeland will just let it bounce. And it'll be down at about the 31-yard line. Both offenses sputtering early. In Buffalo, it's nothing, nothing. Tom Hammond, Chris Collinsworth, Rich Stadium in Buffalo. We have 6:22 remaining in the opening quarter with the Patriots and the Bills scoreless. Second possession for Buffalo. They begin from their own 31-yard line. Blitz coming on. The handoff to Thurman Thomas. Takes it short of the 35-yard line. Gain of 3 or 4.
The New England Patriots not afraid to mix it up here. They already coming with some corner and safety blitzes. They know they have to do a little something special defensively to stop Buffalo.
22 yards so far for Thomas. Kelly's pass, incomplete. Short of the intended receiver, more as Don Beebe, as Maurice Hurst is all over Kelly. So Beebe unable to make the shoestring catch.
See if Beebe was able to get his hands underneath that one.
Short hopped it, didn't he? Looked like it.
For the most part, they're not going to give you that ball unless you really come up with it cleanly.
Third down play for Kelly. Sideline pattern through the hands of Brooks, the newest addition to the Buffalo offense. Bill Brooks coming over as an unrestricted free agent from the Colts.
You know, the Buffalo Bills offensively, they don't play a lot of veterans during the course of the preseason. That's because they like to take a good long look at all those young players, but at least thus far offensively, they've been very sloppy.
Troy Brown awaiting the Chris Moore punt. Brown made a fair catch inside his own 10 the first time, an ill-advised move, and he's going to field this one at the 8, but he has some running room. Brown cut down at about the 24-yard line. Pretty good return, though. And New England will have the ball for the third time when we return to Buffalo.
First and 10 at the 25.
Quarterback, he was beaten out for that spot, played tight end instead. Hand off to Russell, and Leonard Russell.
Russell, the ball carrier.
Gains 4 yards to the 30, just short of that 30-yard line.
Leonard Russell was stabbed during the offseason in June. Bill Parcells had really decided to make Leonard Russell his main featured back, kind of like O.J. Anderson was with the New York Giants. And then he got stabbed in June and lost a lot of blood. And there were really some doubts as to whether or not he was going to make it back for the opener. He said the biggest problem has been his stamina. He really is having a lot of trouble catching his breath if he has to play too many plays in a row.
Lost a lot of blood. Never had a transfusion. He declined to have one. He gets the call again. And will be a couple of yards short of the first down with Phil Hansen making the tackle. Bill Parcells, he said, one of the marks of a good coach is the ability to be flexible. Therefore, we won't see the smash-mouth football we saw with the Giants.
Yeah, there's a flexible guy for you. I don't believe it. I think he's going to go back to what has been so successful for him for a number of years, and that's running the football, allowing that offensive line, which is better than most people think, to push around some of these defensive lines.
Two tight ends, I formation, third and one. Russell has the Patriot first down to the 40-yard line. Behind the block of Gash, the fullback, Maddox and Williams stop Russell, but not until he had first down yardage.
Two new linebackers, Mark Maddox and Marcus Patton. Patton, the first time that really he's ever played the inside linebacker position, number 53 there. They replace Shane Conlon and Carlton Bailey, both of whom free agents. And at least thus far, they haven't done a great job yet, but we shall see.
Walt Corey, the defensive coordinator, said Patton will be a star someday. Bledsoe's pass knocked down at the line of scrimmage and incomplete. Bledsoe 1 of 7 in the early going.
The two new linebackers, Patton and Maddox. Maddox is the signal caller. And that's what Buffalo wants to see their linebackers do. Take on those running backs coming out of the backfield before they get a chance to get into the route. Remember, you have 5 yards to bump off those receivers. Good play that time by Patton.
Second and 10 for New England. Scoreless first quarter, 3:43 left. Draw play, handoff to Russell.
Russell carries.
2 or 3 yards is all for Russell on his 7th carry of the game. Bruce Smith with the tackle. There is the 9 rushes, 4 passes, and
from the flexible coach.
Yeah, right. He was saying because Bledsoe can pass, we're going to pass. But it looks like the smash mouth football all over again.
Yeah, I think Bill Parcells saw what I saw that first series, that Drew Bledsoe looked a little nervous. He probably just wants to allow him to come out here and get a little calm down. And that's what this drive has done.
Parcells saying they had simplified things for Bledsoe, especially in the game management areas and his reads as well. Third down pass is complete. Taken by Gash, close to a first down across midfield. It'll depend on the spot of the football here.
Decision time.
Kelso making the stop for Buffalo. It is enough for a New England first down.
Nice job by Bledsoe here. They had the blitz coming in the middle of just man-to-man coverage and able to beat that. They did pick up enough for the first down.
First and 10.
Buffalo defenders telling us yesterday that as they watched preseason film of Bledsoe, that he appeared to be reading only one side of the defense. Hand off to Russell. Blockers in front. Cuts up and is stopped in his tracks by Marcus Patton. Great play by Patton. Shed the blockers and stood up Russell.
No surprise to see Marcus Patton making that kind of a play. His mom was a linebacker. She played in a women's professional league for the L.A. Dandelions, and I guarantee you Barbara would be awfully proud of that hit.
Well, he was up to the praise of Walt Corey that time. Two starts in 91, five a season ago, and being counted on heavily by the Bills in 93. Like an equipment problem with Leonard Russell's helmet as play was stopped for a moment. Now New England set for a second and nine play. Might be setting up a screen. It is, and it's dropped by Russell. Henry Jones had good penetration of the blocking, though, and seemed about ready to pounce on Russell had he caught the football.
Boy, I tell you what, they had that screen pass set up. This is a major mistake by Russell. They've got everyone inside dumping it out, blockers in front.
All he had to do was cut inside of Jones there, and he would have gone a long way.
And the first little rumbling of an ulcer for Bill Parcells.
Third and nine. They've converted half so far. Bledsoe is 2 of 6. Two tight ends now, Cook and Coates. Good protection. Now it collapses, and Bledsoe sacked by Cornelius Bennett. First sack of the season for Bennett, and number one of Bledsoe's career.
Don't blame the offensive line for this one. They gave Bledsoe plenty of time here, although he made the right decision. When it's third down and long and you're not in field goal range, take as long as you possibly can to try and get that ball down the field. Whether you have to punt it from the 45 or the 50 doesn't really make any difference.
Saxon has struggled here in the first quarter thus far. Two subpar punts. And another low line drive punt. Fielded by Copeland. Just tripped up as he falls across the 30-yard line.
Parcells may end up cutting Mike Saxon at halftime if he doesn't pick it up.
1:02 left in the first, scoreless game. Thomas. New England defense stringing it out a little bit, but Thomas still managed to gain 8 before he was dragged down by Chris Singleton.
This is exactly what I would do if I were Marv Levy and Tom Bresnahan, the offensive coordinator. You're struggling offensively. Get the ball in the hands of your stars. Let Thurman Thomas, let Andre Reed get you back on track.
Thomas dodges one tackler in the backfield and takes it for a first down. You expect Drew Bledsoe to be a little shaky, but Jim Kelly only 1 of 4 in the first quarter with 20 seconds left.
I don't know if it's all Jim Kelly or the job that Maurice Hurst has been doing on his wide receivers. Maurice Hurst, who's going through some contract squabbles with the New England Patriots, has been just outstanding so far in this one.
Nickel defense for the Patriots, closing seconds of the first quarter. Kelly's pass on target to midfield. Andre Reed in traffic with Rod Smith all over him as the first quarter comes to an end. 8-yard gain. That's the end of the first quarter in Buffalo with the Bills and Patriots in a scoreless tie. Line, first play of the second quarter coming up, and so far it's been a Parcells-type game. Thomas. Great run by Thurman Thomas. Dodging tacklers all the way. He's down to the 40-yard line. Buffalo first down.
The offensive line for the Bills starting to establish themselves. John Davis, Parker, Howard, Ballard up front beginning to push around this Patriots front line.
From the no huddle, again it's Thurman Thomas to the line of scrimmage and forward for a yard before he's stopped by Ray Agnew.
Ray Agnew with the tackle. A gain of one.
It's not been a game full of offensive fireworks so far.
But this is Bill Parcells football. He will gladly trade punts for about three quarters with the Buffalo Bills and then take his shot at winning this thing in the fourth quarter.
Second and nine for Kelly and the Bills. Again, Kelly drills it complete to Metzelaar as his tight end. He's got a first down at the New England 30-yard line. 10-yard gain.
First down.
That's the sharpest ball we've seen Jim Kelly throw so far today. And a great job by Pete Metzelaar at the end of this play by just holding out the ball and extending it over the first down marker.
Chris Singleton was all over him. Thomas squirts through the middle to the 25-yard line. Gain of five. Ray Agnew again dragging down Thurman Thomas, but not before he had a good gain. Thomas starting to get his legs under him. He's carried 10 times for 48 yards.
The great backs almost disappear when they get in there. They get so low and make all their moves on the run. Thurman Thomas, just outstanding.
Blitz coming. Kelly keeps. Stumbles forward to a first down inside the 20. He'll say he dived. Looked to me like he fell down.
Now, you can't tell me that play's in the playbook. Something had to go wrong with that one, but somehow it worked. Looked like the fake reverse, and they were going to try to throw the ball. And Jim, I don't know, maybe he thought that he was going to take a sack. Believe me, Jim Kelly does not want to be running the naked bootleg. I know the guy.
First down at the 18. Buffalo threatening. Oh, that pass almost intercepted. Beebe tightly covered on the play by Rene Thompson. And Kelly went down after he delivered.
I like the no call by the officials. There is clearly a bump by Rene Thompson, but he has every right to that football. Don Beebe does not have a clear path to the ball. Rene Thompson in perfect position, perfectly legal as well.
Kelly is only 3 of 7, 21 yards. Audible at the line from Kelly. Thomas. Inside the 15-yard line.
Andre Tippett makes a stop.
This is where traditionally Bill Parcells goes into a four-across look in the secondary. You get down inside the 15-yard line. Rather than playing two up or three back, whatever, he'll just put four deep right on the end zone and dare you to throw the ball.
Third and six. Draw play, Thomas jumped away from one man, still on his feet to the 10-yard line. It'll be a yard short of the first down. Patriots came out of that pile with a football, but Thomas was ruled down. Mike Pitts made the tackle, stopping Thomas short of the first down.
In a five, it's fourth and one.
Really an easy decision here for Marv Levy. It is a very long one. But he wants to put the New England Patriots in a position to have to play catch-up. They want to see Drew Bledsoe have to throw the football.
Christie, you see his 92 numbers. This one will be a 28-yarder. And from 28 yards out, Steve Christie boots it through. And the Buffalo Bills take the lead. 11:39 left in the second quarter, 3-0 Bills. Has given the Buffalo Bills a 3-0 lead on the New England Patriots. 11:39 left in the second quarter. Christie set to kick off. And the ball blows off the tee.
Troy Brown and
clouds moving in here at Rich Stadium. The game began with mostly sunny skies, pleasant temperatures, but you see the wind picking up and whipping the flags atop the stadium. Here's Christie's kick with Brown and Crittenden deep. This will be Brown from the 10. Good return. Troy Brown to the 37-yard line. Good field position for the Patriots. Now let's go to Jim Lampley for an NFL Live update.
All right, Tom Hammond, take a look at the 291st touchdown pass of Dan Marino's career. Makes him number two all-time in the category behind Tarkenton. A 40-yarder down the middle to Keith Jackson in the Hoosier Dome that ties the Dolphins with the Colts 7-7 in the first. Back to Tom Hammond.
All right, Jim, Marino with that touchdown pass. The Indianapolis touchdown came on a 56-yard fumble recovery by Rodney Culver as O.J. McDuffie, the Miami rookie, coughed it up. Leonard Russell backs his way. He turned his backside to get a couple of yards to the 40 before he's tackled by Jeff Wright.
Gain of 2 and 2nd and 8.
Jeff Wright, of course, made the big money during the course of the offseason. He was given an offer sheet by San Francisco, and then Buffalo matched it. He said, you know, it's tough for a millionaire to leave that country club and go back to playing nose tackle.
He said, I got my working clothes on. He had a T-shirt and jeans on as he met with us the day before the game. And we asked him if he were still hungry, and he says, I just try to make each play its individual game and win each time. Flags fly as the play is stopped before it gets going.
Flag on the play.
Bruce Armstrong might have moved prematurely for the Patriots.
Well, now it's a little different scenario.
Before the snap, the right tackle broke his stance. False start. 5 yards. Still 2nd down.
Bill Parcells had to watch that last drive by Buffalo and think that their offense is beginning to get it in gear. He's down only 3-0. You don't want to get too crazy here, being a 14-point underdog. But maybe time to begin to open it up just a bit with Drew Bledsoe.
Saw those scores a moment ago. Joe Montana has thrown his first touchdown pass as a Chief. Bledsoe across the middle. Tough catch made. Beautiful reception by Marv Cook. Now they say incomplete. I thought he caught it. Bledsoe couldn't believe it either. Did you see the look on his face?
Must have had it bounce. Bill Parcells told us yesterday that Marv Cook is a much different tight end. Yeah, clearly it did.
Yep, from that angle, you can see it. He had his back to us. I thought he caught it.
Right. Is a much different tight end than he's used to having. He's used to having really a third tackle out there at tight end. He's more of a pass receiver. Marv Cook told us that the first thing he did when he heard that Parcells was named the head coach was go out and get a neck roll.
Brisby, Timpson, and McMurtry, three wides in for New England. Let's hope from the shotgun. In trouble. Managed to evade a couple of tacklers and then is caught from behind and taken down after a gain of 2 by Cornelius Bennett. Well, Parcells said Bledsoe will surprise you. He looks gangly, but he can run a little bit. But that time, Bennett tracked him down from behind.
Yeah, he can run, but he can't run as fast as Cornelius Bennett. Watch Bledsoe, really nothing working down the field. Bennett had taken the inside rush. Now, look how far back he is to come make that play. Cornelius Bennett, a happy man that he's back at outside linebacker. He said he didn't like that inside job.
Well, Saxon on to punt again. It's been an adventure so far. Again, a low punt. Flag down. Copeland cuts back, stops short of the 30-yard line. We'll check the penalty marker. Michael Timpson made the tackle for New England, and it looks like it will be against the Patriots.
I believe it's going to be a hold on the up back.
We'll take a timeout here with 9:39 left in the first half. Buffalo up by 3. With producer Vic Frank and director Joe Assetti, Tom Hammond, Chris Collinsworth, Rich Stadium in Buffalo. 9:39 left in the second quarter with Buffalo leading New England 3-0. Kenneth Davis, one of the best backup running backs in the NFL, makes his first appearance for the Bills. They have 3 wides, too, as Kelly will go to the air, and it's intercepted. Intercepted by Rene Thompson, the old New York Giant, cut in front of the intended receiver to pick it off for New England. Don Beebe was the man that Kelly was shooting for, and Kelly goes down in the teeth of the rush as well.
Rene Thompson with just an outstanding play, cutting in front of Bill Brooks, and that was thrown a little bit behind Brooks, but just give credit to the free agent from the New York Giants, Bill Parcells, obviously liking Rene Thompson when he had him with the Giants, and you can see why. Not only a good special teamers, but playing pretty well in the secondary.
So the pass intended for Brooks, and Beebe made the tackle. And New England with the first offensive break of the game. Cook and Coates, two tight ends on this first down from the 38 of Buffalo. Leonard Russell bounces off the pile, manages Leonard to fall Russell. Forward to the 35-yard line. He got about 3 yards out of it before Darrell Talley pinned him for good.
A lot of coaches right after a turnover will come out and try to come up with a big play offensively, maybe throw one down the field. I'm not sure that Parcells comfortable enough yet with the play of Drew Bledsoe to allow him to do that after the first real big break of the game.
Parcells and Levy, the same coaching combatants from Super Bowl 25. Coates is out and Gash in the backfield now with Russell. Bledsoe, oh, dangerous pass. Nate Odoms was all over the intended Bledsoe receiver for the Patriots, Greg McMurtry.
Incomplete. Well, they say that Drew Bledsoe is not sensitive. He better not be when they watch the film on this one tomorrow, because he's going to get chewed. They're all over his intended receiver, and you saw the bump by Darrell Talley just knocked the guy down. That really could have been illegal contact 5 yards down the field.
Should have been. So the Bills got away with one there. Meanwhile, Bledsoe only 2 of 8. This is 3rd and 7. Flags down.
Flag on the play.
McMurtry was in motion, and it appeared the Bills came across prematurely. Were they drawn? Yes, they were.
69. False start.
Eugene Chung, the left guard. First-round draft choice out of Virginia Tech in his second year with premature movement.
And that's what Bill Parcells just absolutely hates. You get a big break in the ballgame. Look at him saying, you get a big break in the game, you don't jump off sides, do stupid stuff. We're not that good. We've got to take advantage of these mistakes.
Bledsoe in the shotgun with Russell next to him. Brisby, Timpson, McMurtry, three wide receivers in the game. 3rd and 12. Bledsoe with time and a man wide open, and he found him. Brisby, the rookie, with his first NFL reception. The second-round draft choice out of Northeast Louisiana takes it in front of Matt Darby for a New England first down, 17-yard strike.
Parcells loves this kid. Vincent Brisby, number 82. He can really fly. Did a great job for New England in the preseason. 7 catches, 154 yards, 2 touchdowns, averaged 22 yards a catch, and that guy likes it. That was a big league throw. That's the first one we've seen today.
Yeah, you saw the spark of greatness in the arm of Bledsoe that time. 17-yarder, his longest pro completion so far. Leonard Russell tripped up in the backfield, fumbled the ball, picked up by the Buffalo Bills. Cornelius Bennett now in a foot race. Bennett being chased from behind. And now the ball loose again. Scramble for it at the 25 of New England.
What kind of a play was that?
And New England gets it back at the 25-yard line. What a bizarre play. And now they say Buffalo's ball at the 25.
Well, they name Cornelius Bennett Biscuit. That time he coughed up the biscuit after about, you know, those big guys, they're not used to running that far. Watch the play. Russell fumbles. Now Biscuit's going to pick up the biscuit. Take off, make a nice move on Drew Bledsoe. And now the foot race is on.
Well, he just lost it. It just came loose.
It just fell out.
And the officials at first signaled that New England had recovered.
You know, those big guys, they more than about 40 yards, and they're dead. That's it. Biscuits, he's moving his best as he can, and they're lucky.
Here's the Buffalo play. Thurman Thomas.
I don't know if I've ever seen a double fumble like that before.
And the officials, too, signaling that New England had gotten it back initially before they ruled it Buffalo's ball. So New England makes a big defensive play on the interception, then a fumble, and returned by Bennett, who's gassed on the sideline. Here's Thomas. Thomas to the 10. White and Barnett on the stop after a gain of 11. First down, Buffalo at the 10-yard line.
Boy, we laugh, but that play really a dagger in the heart of the Patriots. They had it down there in field goal range at least, and now it looks like they may go down 10.
Thomas, delayed handoff to the line of scrimmage, no more.
This Harlan Barnett made the stop.
Harlan Barnett got him from behind before the play really developed.
First real test now for Bill Parcells' defense. They have a bad break. They create the turnover. The offense screws it up, and now they've got their back against the wall. Bill Parcells wants to know if this defense has a change of attitude over last year. Will they stand tall here?
Carwell Gardner, the only setback. Gets the hand on Thomas. Thomas inside the 5 to the 4 yard line.
It's third and goal from the
It'll
four.
Be third and goal for the Buffalo Bills, just inside the New England 5.
I think this is the toughest call for a head coach. You've got third down and a little bit more than four. He's going to take a timeout and talk about it. They are a bit confused.
Timeout, Marv Levy of Buffalo, 6:13 left in the half. Buffalo trying to add to its lead.
We were mistaken. Cornelius Bennett had not one fumble recovery, but two on the same play. You see him diving back into the pile and making it. Really nice hustle by Cornelius Bennett. He'll use that in contract negotiations next year.
That sets up a third and goal from the 4 yard line for the Buffalo Bills, already leading 3-0. Parcells trying to rally that defense.
Kelly likes the slant play here.
Three wide receivers in the game. For the corner of the end zone, touchdown to Brooks. Bill Brooks with his first reception goes for a touchdown. His first Buffalo Bills catch. And the man who went to Boston University, Bill Brooks.
This is a veteran play here. Bill Brooks just going for rebound positions, gets turned around. The play was set up, though, by Jim Kelly making a slight roll, and that was an easier throw from the rollout position because it gave him a better angle in. Good play design. I like that play.
4 yard touchdown toss, and Christie will try to tack on the extra point. And it's good. A Leonard Russell fumble leads to the Buffalo touchdown as the Bills go up on the Patriots 10-0.
The play was really made by Jim Kelly rolling out here, which gave him a better throwing lane in here to Bill Brooks. Rebound position by Brooks. The angle much easier because of the rollout. Clever play design by Marv Levy and his staff.
And Kelly put the ball where only Brooks could catch it. Low and outside, and it's the first Buffalo touchdown of the 93 season. Jim Kelly now with 106 touchdown passes the last four seasons, tops in the NFL. A five-play drive set up by the Leonard Russell fumble. Christie's kickoff reaches the end zone and is down there by Ray Crittenden.
Down by Crittenden in the end zone. It'll be first and 10 New England from the 20.
Well, it's a whole new ball game now for Drew Bledsoe and Bill Parcells. While they were trading punts, yeah, you can play it a little bit more conservatively, but not anymore. You're down 10-0. The Bills apparently have their offense back in gear. It's time for this young man to show why he was the number one pick in this year's draft.
So those scores flashing by. Joe Montana hitting his first 9 passes for the Kansas City Chiefs. Meanwhile, Steve Young and Jerry Rice have hooked up for 2 touchdown passes against the Steelers. Kevin Turner with his first carry for New England. That's only about a yard. Thrown back by the center of the Buffalo defense.
Gain of 2 at 2nd and 8.
You know, to go back to that fumble, double fumble recovery by Cornelius Bennett. You remember yesterday that he told us he was still having problem with a thumb that he hurt last year playing inside linebacker. That was why he was so happy. That had something to do maybe with why he fumbled that ball.
Bennett went to head coach Marv Levy and asked to be moved back outside so he wouldn't take as much punishment, perhaps add some longevity to his career. Bledsoe's in trouble. Try to wrap up early and then recovered to drill one complete to McMurtry. It looked like he was wrapping up in anticipation of going down. At the last second, zipped it for 16 yards.
First and 10.
Boy, I tell you what, I'm beginning to understand why Bill Parcells likes this kid so much. He stood there in the pocket, waited. Give credit to that offensive line, gave him time, and then threw an absolute bullet.
First down, New England. Cornelius Bennett out of the game, getting a rest as the trainers take a look at him. Still winded. Plenty of time. Bledsoe hits Marv Cook as tight end, and Cook will be about a yard shy of the first down with Mark Maddox wrapped all over him.
Maybe that thumb giving him some serious problems. That appears to be
second and one.
at what they're looking.
Uh-huh.
That or oxygen. I don't know what the problem is. That was a nice job, though, by Drew Bledsoe. That was the first time today that I've seen him go to the second receiver. He wanted Brisby, wasn't there, came back and laid it off.
Second and a yard after that Marv Cook 9-yard reception. Oh, Sam Gash tripped up upon getting the handoff, and there's Bruce Smith. You hear Bruce from the crowd, and that
really a good battle going on over there between Bruce Armstrong and Bruce Smith, two all-pro players. Of course, Bruce Smith, 5 times a Pro Bowler. There had always been a lot of question marks as to whether or not he could play the run, whether he was just a pass rusher type of guy. But I think the biggest difference in him lately has been his stepping it up against the run.
Coates and Cook, two tight ends, third and one, New England. They trail 10-0. Tailback, Leonard Russell. It'll be close.
Now what do you do? You're down 10. Fourth down, apparently, in just a little bit. Depends on how Parcells feels this game is going.
Stay out there, he says to his offense. Stay out there.
Yeah, he's feeling like that this game is beginning to get just a little bit one-sided. And okay. If he's going to have any chance to win it, he's going to have to make something happen right here.
$80,000 come to their feet. Fourth, less than a yard. Ball on the 46-yard line of the Patriots, and Bledsoe will ask for timeout.
That ought to quiet the crowd down.
Bledsoe says one of his biggest problems so far has been understanding the terminology in the formations, and I don't think he wanted to take a chance there.
Yeah, and Bill Parcells checking Bledsoe's sensitivity again as he gave him a little lip there on the sideline. But you're right. He said that the number one problem that he's had so far on the field has been just getting those signals. There was some confusion there as to whether or not they were going to go for the first down or not. A little late getting the play in, and obviously, a play this big in the ball game, they want to get it right.
Scott Seacule's there, the backup quarterback. Did you ever play for a coach as vociferous as Parcells?
Oh, yeah. I played for a guy named Charlie Pell and a guy named Forrest Gregg. I got it plenty of times.
Were you sensitive?
Not after they got finished with me.
Meanwhile, Walt Corey, the defensive coordinator for the Bills, trying to stop this fourth down play. There's that familiar swizzle stick in his mouth. A man in Ohio sent him 10,000 of them. He forgot it the other day, Friday, as a matter of fact. He said he couldn't even talk, could barely drive home without one. Cook, Coates, and Brandon Moore, three tight ends for the Patriots.
Watch the play action.
There it is. And it's complete for the first down. Ben Coates, still on his way. He's got the touchdown. It's 54 yards, fourth and less than one. They go to the play action as Chris predicted. Bledsoe found Ben Coates, the tight end, on the sideline, and Coates rambled all the way into the end zone.
Are you kidding me? Ben Coates went down the sideline and somebody just absolutely waved at him like they thought the play was over or something. I think it was Nate Odom's. Very simple play action. Great call here. I love the call. Easy first down. Now watch Nate Odom's. He goes for the ball. He tried to come up with the turnover and blew the tackle.
The crowd, which a moment ago was absolutely delirious trying to rally the defense, is stunned after Bledsoe throws his first NFL touchdown pass. But give Ben Coates the credit. He did most of the work, a short completion, and then Coates rambles to the end zone. Number one.
You got to know that one feels good. No matter how much money you make in life, there's nothing quite like throwing your first touchdown pass.
Has the a stunning turn of events in Buffalo, and the Patriots are back in the game. Aaron Jones with a good defensive play for the Patriots. The fans reacting as some of the players were still mixing it up, apparently, after the whistle, and Thomas a little gimpy.
That's what they're upset about. You don't want to lose a star player on an incomplete pass and then a little extracurricular activity after the play. Believe me, though, Thurman Thomas not going out of the game.
Jim Kelly hitting only 4 of 10 passes so far for 25 yards. He has a touchdown pass to Brooks. He's also had one picked off. This one complete, wide open. Metzelaar is the tight end. He's across the 30 and has a Buffalo first down, stopped by Todd Collins.
Todd Collins that time has to be a little more alert within his zone. He let Metzelaar just go down and run a simple option route, and Todd Collins acted like he never even saw him come into the zone.
Kelly again delivers. This one complete to Brooks. Brooks with a juggling catch on the sideline, a gain of 10 yards, and Kelly has the Bills moving here with 2:26 remaining in the first half.
Brooks over 5,000 yards receiving in his career, 7 years with the Colts, second only to Raymond Berry in Colts history.
Kenneth Davis comes into the game now and lines up in the slot to the left on a wing. Kelly, crossing pattern, complete to Reed.
Kelly's pass complete to Andre Reed.
Andre Reed, some had questioned his ability to catch over the middle and take the punishment as he did early in his career. He does it right there as we come to the two-minute warning. 2 minutes left in the first half from Ritz Stadium in Buffalo with the Bills leading the Patriots 10-7. Donuts for the team and gets Parcells his Gatorade in practice. All the typical rookie Harrison that goes on an NFL team. Bill Brooks, the intended receiver, as that Kelly toss falls incomplete.
But we're seeing a trend as Jim Kelly has looked repeatedly to Bill Brooks. I think he likes Bill Brooks as a receiver. Hard for me to look at number 80 and not say James Lofton, though.
Lofton, one of the primary targets of Kelly a year ago. Kelly chased from the pocket. Pumps it once and decides to pull it down and run, and he slides for a first down. Tippett and Thompson covered him, but Kelly able to scramble for a Buffalo first down.
I'm not sure about that mark, because when Jim Kelly begins his slide, he was short of the first down marker. That was a very generous mark. Remember, where he begins the slide is where the ball should be placed down. That's a bad mark.
Thurman Thomas breaks to the outside, doors his head, and takes it to the 40-yard line, a gain of about 7 yards.
And what made it significant, of course, was it was third down. The Bills would have had to give up the football, but instead this drive's still alive.
With a minute 15 left. Second down for Buffalo, the ball at the New England 41. 10-7 Bills. Kelly strong arms it to Reed. Reed still on his feet, still going. Reed, touchdown.
He had to make at least 5 people miss to get that one in the end zone. Wow.
Everybody in the secondary seemingly had a shot at him. 41-yard strike. Christie adds the extra point.
People, this is just a thing of beauty. Bobble the ball for a bit. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Unbelievable. Jimmy, you'll get credit for a touchdown pass. You owe him a round of drinks for that one.
Andre Reed.
He's had 3 100-yard receiving days versus the Patriots. His best game was last year, 9 catches, 168 yards, and a touchdown against New England. He may be on his way again today.
And over the last 4 years, Kelly has hit Reed 31 times on a scoring pass.
Get used to watching that play. That'll be on about 1,000 different highlight shows for the next year.
What a great effort by Andre Reed in the final minute of the first half to put the Bills back up again by 10 points.
touchdown play and received Christie the extra point. Makes this season's total 1,700.
Christie for the kickoff with Brown and Crittenden deep for the Patriots. Short kickoff this time, taken by one of the upbacks on a fair catch at the 25-yard line. Ben Coates, who scored the touchdown, takes that kickoff. But don't forget, coming up at intermission, the Domino's Pizza NFL Live Halftime Report. Lampley, Ditka, Simpson bring you the scores and highlights from around this opening week of the NFL season. O.J. Simpson, by the way, will be honored here at Rich Stadium later on this season on the 20th anniversary of his 2,000-yard rushing season.
Still one of the most amazing things I think I've ever seen in football.
Has it been that long ago? 17-7. What do the Patriots do now? Play it safe or let Bledsoe try to air it out? They got three wide receivers in the game. Timpson joins Brisby and McMurtry. Shotgun formation. Tipped pass incomplete.
Bledsoe's pass. Tipped at the line of scrimmage incomplete.
If you're wondering about a pass interference call there, once the ball is tipped, all the wide receivers are live meat, so they can absolutely come
live meat.
Hey, believe me, I've been toasted on tipped balls. You begin to look around, watch the ball's tipped, and then Darrell Talley has every right to grab him, hit him, do whatever he wants to do.
Jeff Wright, the man that tipped that one. Screen pass. Russell holds on to this one and makes about a 10-yard gain out of it before Wright tracks him down. Clock still ticks inside 40 seconds.
A couple of timeouts remaining. Still time to make something happen. Wouldn't be surprised to see him go back across the middle. That seems to be where they've had the most success.
Final 30 seconds of the half. First down, New England. Flags down.
Well, there goes a few more strands of hair.
Cook and Harlow got a...
For the snap, false start on the offense, number 85 and 77. 5 yards, is still first down.
Cook and Harlow got a head start, and that'll cost the Patriots 5.
Been some sloppy play thus far for the New England Patriots, a couple of times jumping off sides.
First and 15 now. From the New England 31. Bledsoe's in trouble. Manages to run away and out of bounds. Now, he took a loss on the play running out of bounds. Well, it was close to the line of scrimmage. But that's where the new intentional grounding rule could have come into play.
Exactly. Once you get outside the tight end area, the quarterback is allowed to throw the ball at least to the line of scrimmage, and it is not intentional grounding. You can't do it in the pocket, but you can do it outside the tackle area. Now Bill Parcells may want to take a shot here. Why not throw the ball down the field, see if you can come up with something cheap. A field goal would sure come in handy now.
17 seconds left, and Buffalo up 17-7. Four wide receivers now for the Patriots. Three set right, and a snap over Bledsoe's head. Picks it up on the bounce and downs it at about the 7-yard line. Covered there by Bennett with 12 seconds left in the half.
Well, Bill, it's time to take it on into the locker room and try to get out of this first half. Good heads-up play, though, by Bledsoe. Just take it, ball down. Now you'll take a knee and go in at the half.
Bledsoe not trying to pick it up and run with it. Did the smart thing by downing it. It's third down for New England, so the Bills take a timeout, hoping to get the ball back here with 12 seconds left.
Make sure you have plenty of new.
I don't think Bill Parcells is too upset, though, with what he's seen. He knows he's got a young football team. They're probably a couple of years away. Drew Bledsoe has shown a few things here in the first half, and they're only down 10 points. You don't want to give up anything now. Obviously, that was a good break for them to get the football back.
I don't know what they could possibly be discussing over there. They're going to have to hand the ball off and hope that... they can kill some seconds.
If they hand the ball off here, I'll jump out of this
window.
Well,
Bledsoe, take a knee.
Take a knee. Get out of here. That's what you do at this point. If he hands it off, Bill will probably jump out of a window, too.
Two offenses sputtering in the first quarter and then coming alive in the second period. Bledsoe threw a touchdown pass. Kelly pitched two to go with a Christie field goal. Brooks had one reception. Reed had one TD catch. Well, they do hand it off. Sam Gash got out of bounds with 7 seconds left. It'll be fourth down for New England. And now they'll have to punt. I don't know why he ran out of bounds.
Yeah, but neither does Bill. But that was a good call, and simply because it gave them a little more room to punt the football here. But Bill Parcells certainly didn't want to see him go out of bounds.
Russell Copeland awaits the Saxon punt with 7 seconds left in the half. They put the pressure on Saxon, and he gets it away. And the Bills will just let it roll, and the first half will come to a close. Jim Kelly with 2 touchdown passes, one to Bill Brooks, one to Andre Reed, who had a great run after the reception, accounting for the 2 Buffalo touchdowns to go with a Christie field goal, and Drew Bledsoe with a touchdown toss to his tight end Ben Coates. And Hurst recovered in a hurry, knocked it down, and nearly intercepted it.
Maurice Hurst is just having one heck of a game. Watch the reaction on Beebe. Plants his foot, drives. Remember, he's in the middle of a giant contract dispute right now. Parcells says he doesn't hold it personally against him, and I can see why. That guy can play.
He's making a case for a new contract,
well,
isn't he?
I tell you, he ought to get it this week.
Maurice Hurst has had a great game in his 5th year out of Southern University in Baton Rouge. 4th round draft choice. Nickel defense for the Patriots, and Kelly throws it. His arm might have been hit as he released the ball, and it will fall incomplete. And the Bills will punt after their first second half possession.
4th and 8.
It's exactly what New England needed to start the second half. 3 and out. Coming with just a 3-man rush, maybe sending Chris Slade. That's the rookie who came and apparently got a piece of Kelly's arm.
Moore to punt. Troy Brown has a bead on it. Takes it at the 42 and is hit immediately. He spins away, and then on the second time, Carwell Gardner gets him to the turf. Determined effort by Carwell Gardner of the Bills.
Well, they're not short of hustle, these Buffalo Bills. We saw Cornelius Bennett bounce up off the ground and make a second fumble recovery. And here, Carwell Gardner gets right back up. This Brown's a dangerous kick returner. Good play.
Only a 36-yard punt by Moore, however. And New England with relatively good field position in the second half. Bledsoe hitting on 50% so far. And the Patriots down 10. The ball is at their own 39. Bledsoe turns and hits Gash, and Gash is to the 45-yard line. A gain of 6. Close call for Bledsoe, but he got rid of it. Henry Jones tackling Gash.
Boy, I love Henry Jones in the secondary. I think that he has made one tremendous difference for this Bills team. He was a Pro Bowler a year ago, tied for the NFL lead with 8 interceptions. He just sniffed that play out. It looked like it was going to go for big yardage in the beginning, but Henry Jones unraveled it.
Made the Pro Bowl last year, was also the second leading Buffalo tackler in addition to those 8 interceptions. Leonard Russell.
Russell, the ball carrier.
Russell stopped about a yard short of the first down by Marvkus Patton.
Those two new inside linebackers have played fairly well here. Mark Maddox, the other linebacker, is the signal caller. This is only his 2nd start of his career. So those two guys, a lot of pressure, and Marvkus Patton, his 1st start. As an inside linebacker, so really a new look. But one thing that they like is the added speed that they get over Shane Conlon and Carlton Baylor.
It was Maddox, number 55, who calls the defensive signals and said he never thought he'd get a chance to start in the NFL. He's gotten it. He's played well. Gash bounces ahead into Buffalo territory, and he has a New England 1st down.
Parcells telling us yesterday that Gash and Kevin Turner, the other fullback, basically interchangeable. He really doesn't care who's in the ball game between those two. Gash, the cousin of Thane Gash, who's with the 49ers.
Bruce Smith looks like he was calling to the sideline for a substitution, and he'll take a timeout in order to get a sub in. I don't know if it's an equipment problem or an injury. The way he's grimacing, it might be an injury to the right shoulder of Bruce Smith. Timeout Buffalo with 12:31 left in the third.
I believe Bruce Smith is right here, and you'll see he just gets crushed in the bottom of a big pile. Maybe a stinger on that shoulder.
New England with a live play down the sideline into coverage, double coverage. Bledsoe threw it. Odoms and Kelso were covering Vincent Brisby, and then Bledsoe was knocked down as he let the pass go.
And Mark Kelso took out Nate Odoms on the play. Watch Drew Bledsoe take a shot from Phil Hansen as that one was released. Good quick release by Bledsoe, but the biggest hit on the play was Mark Kelso taking out his own man, Nate Odoms.
There's a look at Nate Odoms. Oliver Barnett, by the way, has replaced Bruce Smith in the Buffalo lineup. Fourth year out of Kentucky. Sometimes starter last year for the Bills. Cook and Coates, two tight ends. Second down play. It's a play action pass. Bledsoe put a little touch on it that time, but Darrell Talley had good coverage on Cook, the intended receiver. It'll bring up a third down for New England. Smith still on the sideline, tending to that shoulder injury.
And the worst part about a shoulder injury in the National Football League is you can't take off that jersey and the shoulder pads. They're like screwed to your body because the defensive lineman, they don't want the offensive lineman to be able to grab them, you know? So they got it on there so tight that you can't just take it off and take a look at the shoulder.
Nickel defense for the Bills this time, third and 10 facing the Patriots. Bennett came with a rush. And the pass, as a flag flies, goes incomplete. McMurtry, the intended receiver.
McMurtry is incomplete. There's a flag on the play.
Jerry Austin will get the call and
holding, holding number 29.
A hold against Buffalo, and that'll be an automatic first down.
Wow. James Williams, their starting cornerback. That was one of the situations that the Buffalo's defensive coordinator, Walt Curry, was concerned about. Watch number 29 Williams off the line of scrimmage grab a little jersey. That's what they're going to call. Boy, I tell you what, if that's holding, I could have gotten it on every play I ever played in the NFL.
Now, no sour grapes. Here's Bruce Smith back on the field for the Bills. Draw play, Gash. He's got room. He's got a first down. Gash pounds ahead to the 30-yard line of the Bills before Mark Kelso takes him down. A 14-yard ramble by Sam Gash, the fullback.
And the key block was thrown on Mark Maddox. Flipped upside down on the play. The inside linebacker, the signal caller that we told you about, he was upended. And that's what created the hole. Here's a nice drive working by New England. Their defense came out, did the job. Three and out by the Buffalo Bills offensively. And now New England's offense doing the job as well.
Tie game in Cleveland as you see the other scores. And there's Bruce Smith coming across the line. I didn't see anybody move for the Patriots. That could be five offside against Buffalo.
Bruce Smith is notorious in this league for jumping offsides.
Encroachment, number 78 of the defense, 5 yards, still first down.
Quickest first step in the NFL?
Yeah, sometimes too quick. Yeah, that's what he does. Bruce Smith, he's going to gamble. He figures that during the course of a season that he'll try to get that rolling start and it'll give him some advantage. But, you know, he hurts them in some situations as well by jumping off as many times as he does.
And speaking of hurting, he's off the field again with that shoulder problem. Gash. Short gain up the middle.
The scrum. That's Bill Parcells. He got him down in a first down and five situation. Many coaches would consider that a passing down because essentially you've got a free play by picking up the cheap 5 yards. But Bill Parcells wanting to smash that thing in there, make sure of a first down. You know, they're not out of this by any means. 17-7, they pick up a touchdown right here, and we've got a whale of a football game. One thing you don't want to do is give an underdog new life, and that's what the Buffalo Bills are doing.
Gash and Russell, the split backs on second and one.
Gash. First down. Good drive by the New England line. They're inside the Buffalo 20.
Oliver Barnett with the tackle. Enough for a first down.
Sam Gash, his second year, played mostly on special teams a season ago. An eighth-round pick in 92. He'd been a short yardage specialist during his career in Penn State, and so far that's kind of what he's doing here, too, just banging it right down the throats, banging it in the middle. But New England's offensive line, especially with Bruce Smith out of there, has taken over to some degree.
Gash only carried five times all last season. Bledsoe will pass across the middle and incomplete, dropped by McMurtry, the intended receiver. Nate Odom's had pretty good coverage.
McMurtry is incomplete. Nate Odom's on the cover.
That hurts. That's a good throw by Drew Bledsoe. McMurtry had it right in his hands. Really no excuse for dropping this ball. Nate Odom's good position, but I don't think he gets there before the ball does.
Nope. Just a dropped pass.
It's not the strength of the New England Patriots, the wide receiver position. McMurtry and the rookie Vincent Brisby, they're high on him, but clearly they need somebody from that group to step up.
Second and 10 from the Buffalo 19. Hand off. Bouncing to the outside is Russell. Leonard Russell knocked out of bounds after he is close to a first down around the Buffalo 10. Marvkus Patton nudged him out of bounds. And the New England drive continues.
Leonard Russell made a nice run here, but I really don't like what he did at the end of the play. They're going to leave themselves with a third and one. Watch him just kind of casually go out of bounds rather than just diving forward. They've got the marker on the field. You get down inside that 10-yard line. I mean, every inch is important. You need to make that one happen.
Lower your head and shoulders, and your momentum ought to carry you for the first down.
You got it.
Moore, Coates, and Cook, three tight ends on this third and less than a yard. Russell, he's got the first down. He's close to the Buffalo 5.
Leonard Russell carries for the first down.
New England looking sharp here to open the third quarter. Looks like a different team almost, with confidence in their offense.
Looks like the Giants, doesn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, really, it does.
The offensive line has been playing great on this drive.
You know, that's Bill Parcells' philosophy. Get those big guys out there, give them a chance to boom, 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 get that running game established, the mentality, the tough guy mentality. And usually you get down inside the 10-yard line, third down and a short one, you don't pick up 5 yards on a play like that.
First and goal, New England. They trail by 10. Bledsoe hands to Russell. Hit in the backfield. He falls to the 4-yard line, tripped up by Phil Hansen. 16th carry of the game by Leonard Russell.
Second and goal.
Good play there by Phil Hansen. He got the penetration. That's what Buffalo hasn't been doing. They're known for getting in the backfield of the opposition. Thus far, we haven't seen much of it, but Phil Hansen came up with a big play. Big moment in the football game now.
8.5 minutes left, third quarter, 17-7 Buffalo. New England knocking on the door. Second and goal from the Buffalo 4. Russell in motion. Gash stood up and driven back by the Buffalo defense. Initial hit by Mark Maddox from his inside linebacker spot. Then he got a lot of help.
Apparently, they're feeling good about the interior line. This is nothing fancy. You talk about smash-mouth football. That's exactly what this is. Just a quick trap to the fullback. That's the second straight time, though, they put Leonard Marshall in motion to the weak side and run that play. They may be giving it away by formation now.
Now spot the ball at the 2, third and goal. Gash and Russell, the split backs. Bledsoe will pass. End zone, complete. Wide open was McMurtry.
Bledsoe's pass.
Second touchdown pass by Drew Bledsoe, the rookie, and McMurtry was wide open.
Mark Maddox got left all alone on Greg McMurtry. I don't know how a wide receiver ended up in man coverage. Look at this. Boy, I tell you, you're not going to win many of those battles. I think the motion threw off the Buffalo Bills defensively and allowed for the mismatch. That's what you try and do down on the goal line, get a faster receiver on a slower linebacker. They worked it to perfection.
Did you see the barber, Harlow, give Bledsoe a high five?
Extra point is good by Sisson, and the New England Patriots in the second half looking strong. They're within 3. He's hit 9 of 19, 2 TDs, no interceptions today. And with the Sisson kickoff, the Buffalo Bills
Russell Copeland downs it in the end zone, and the veteran Jim Kelly now will try to answer the rookie Bledsoe's touchdown drive. There's a penalty marker down. Patriots offside on the kickoff.
Left side of the line was offsides on the kickoff. 5 yards, re-kick.
Bill Parcells can give you a look like no other.
But he's tell us he was taking this head coaching assignment a little differently, but I don't see too many differences.
But, you know, he really was yesterday. When we talked to him, then he seemed more relaxed and at ease. It was almost unbelievable.
Almost joyously happy.
Yeah.
I mean, he just seemed to be doing what he wanted to be doing more than anything in the world. And he was very relaxed, very confident of his team. He said, there's some talent on this team that'll surprise you. And we may have a tough afternoon meeting today, but he thinks they're going to be making progress. Bruce Smith with that right shoulder injury. You talked about peeling the pads off. They've done that, Chris.
And now it hurts. Believe me, it hurts. And I'll tell you something. That's psychological. You put that little piece of foam on an injured shoulder, that's not going to help you much.
Well, the kickoff reaches the end zone again. Same result. Copeland will down it there. Let's go back to that touchdown pass by Bledsoe.
Really a lot of confusion in this Bills secondary. The motion here fouled them up. You'll see them back out in the zone here, but this was clearly a man-to-man. Watch them follow it here. Half man, half zone. Confused Buffalo. That's what led to the touchdown.
McMurtry on the TD catch.
Looked like they shifted from a man to a zone and not everybody made the shift.
So now Kelly's turn to answer with 7:20 left in the third. Thurman Thomas thrown back.
Thomas, the ball carrier.
See if the Buffalo offensive line can do the job that the New England offensive line did on that last drive.
Well, I tell you what, Benson Brown just did a job on Thurman Thomas. Remember, Bill Parcells told us that he could be a dominant player in this league if we could get a few more guys around him.
There's Thomas, who took the hit from Brown, and as you saw, New England has outgained Buffalo so far today. Flags fly.
Now, if they're stopping action, that's
for the snap, encroachment, number 72 of the defense, 5 yards, it's still second down.
You know, once again here, we've got stupid penalties on the part of New England. They put themselves in a position. They just score a touchdown. They've got momentum. Now you give this offense a cheap 5 yards after stopping them on first down. Just dumb mistakes.
Miami and Indianapolis tied at the Hoosier Dome. Detroit having a field day against Atlanta. And Cleveland has come from 14-7 down to go up 3 on the Bengals. Thurman Thomas across the 30 has a Buffalo first down. Barnett wrapping up Thomas.
6 yards.
Boy, is he tough. He just makes something out of nothing more often than not. But that Bruce Smith injury is a big one. I expect Bill Parcells to really try and take advantage of the right side of the defensive line for Buffalo in the next drive.
Thomas closing in on 100. Here's the reverse. Hand it to Reed. Andre Reed with Kelly in front blocking. Takes it out of bounds at about the 44-yard line, or the 46-yard line, excuse me, of the Bills. Barnett forced him out, but it went for 14 yards to Reed.
Nice play when you get a young team, an aggressive team that wants to over-pursue. Give them a little misdirection. That cuts down on the pursuit. Jim Kelly doing the best that he could. Can't quite keep up with Andre Reed, though.
First down, Buffalo. Ball spotted at their own 46-yard line. They lead 17-14. Just over 6 minutes left, third quarter. Thomas. Taking tacklers with him is to midfield. That's a gain of 4 when it appeared nothing was there. Rod Smith finally wrapped up his legs.
I know so much has been made of Will Wolford leaving via free agency, but let's give a plug to John Pina. He's really done a nice job that time driving his man into the turf and setting it up for Thomas.
Pina, the first-round draft choice out of Arizona in his second season, starting at left tackle, number 70. Pass complete to the 45-yard line, just short of the first down. Metzlars, I think that's his third catch of the day, taken down by Chris Singleton.
Gain of five makes it third and one.
Offensively, the Bills really need to make something happen on this drive. The Patriots have the momentum. They're back in the ball game now. May have been a tip ball.
Nevertheless, goes for a reception. Here's a third down play. Kenneth Davis. Davis, I don't believe, made the first down on third and one.
Clearly have to go for it now. Marv Levy will send out his short yardage team and punt it. No.
Yeah, he has Chris Moore coming on the field. So fourth and a yard inside New England territory, and Levy and company elect to punt it away with a three-point lead.
I guess you feel like you've got the better football team, you can do it, but I don't know. I a lot of momentum on the side of the Patriots now. If I'm head coach in the Bills, I'd have gone for that one. Inside the 50-yard line. That's a
Moore's punt straight up. Brown wants to call for a fair catch, can't get close enough, and it takes a New England bounce.
There's also going to be a holding call on Buffalo, the up back, but they'll decline that one. They'll like it just fine at the 30-yard line.
Maddox with a hold. It's declined, and New England will have the ball back. They have the momentum down by a field goal. 14, Buffalo leading, electing to punt on fourth and a yard. The punt only covered 11 yards. Marv Levy might, in retrospect, wish he had gone for it. The worst that could have happened would have been an 11-yard difference.
Of course, he wasn't expecting an 11-yard punt either. But this is a situation now. Bill Parcells, I'll bet you a dollar to a donut, he goes right after Bruce Smith. He's got the bad shoulder. They've got a great tackle in Bruce Armstrong. I would cram it down his throat until he cried.
New England starts from the 34-yard line, trailing by a field goal, 4:20 left in the third. Leonard Russell, blockers in front. Russell got a block from the rookie Todd Rucci and is taken out of bounds after a gain of about four by Cornelius Bennett. That time they ran away from Bruce Smith.
You know what happens sometimes during a ball game is that we and the people at home know more about what's happening than do the coaches on the other sideline. They may not know the full extent of Bruce Smith's injury, the fact that he was wincing when they were taking off the shoulder pads, may not have a full understanding of how hurt he really is.
Russell, straight ahead.
Russell carries again.
To the 41-yard line with Jeff Wright and Phil Hansen tripping him up. Wrapped him up after a 4-yard gain.
One of the things that Jeff Wright told us yesterday, that this isn't really a smash-mouth offense. He said neither were the New York Giants under Bill Parcells. That they really just kind of go for position on you and try and create seams in the defense. It's not a matter of them coming off and really smashing you in the face.
Third and three for the Patriots. Gash and Russell, the split backs. Bledsoe. Off the back of the defender that time, Henry Jones. Leonard Russell out of the backfield was the intended receiver, and it bounced off the back of Jones.
Drew Bledsoe will be playing these Buffalo Bills twice a year, and he'll know better than this in the future. Henry Jones, one of the best man-to-man cover guys at the strong safety position in the National Football League. That time, it's a mismatch, Henry Jones against Leonard Russell. Russell will not win that battle all day.
After a slow start, Saxon's numbers beginning to look pretty good. This is with the wind, a low kick to Copeland. Copeland had a head of steam and bounces off a tackler. Then is ripped to the turf at the 25-yard line. Timeout with 3:01 left in the third. It's a three-point. Meanwhile, Buffalo in a fight for its life against the underdog Patriots here as Davis takes it for a short game.
And we saw Thurman Thomas on the sideline. I wonder if he hurt that neck. Remember, he took a big hit directly on the head. Benson Brown stuck him in the prior series. I wonder if he's not really hurt.
Well, he might be a little shaken up. We're told he can return to the game, but as you pointed out, ice on the neck. Here's a blitz coming, picked up by the Bills. Kelly's pass on a great catch by Brooks. Rene Thompson was draped all over Brooks, and Kelly slow getting up as Vincent Brown came on a blitz from his linebacker spot.
Boy, I tell you, there is a big difference. Great catch here by Brooks. But a big difference in this New England Patriots team. Look how physical they are on both sides. Jim Kelly takes a shot. Bill Brooks takes a shot. Bill Parcells, welcome to New England.
Davis squirts ahead to the 43-yard line. Inside 2 minutes of the third quarter.
I'm not sure the Bills were ready for a game like this. You come in as a two-touchdown favorite. They jump out to a 10-point lead in the first half. It looked like it may just be another rout by the Buffalo Bills. And now all of a sudden, they're in a dogfight.
They lead 17-14 with a minute 37 remaining third quarter. Gardner and Davis in the backfield in the eye. Gardner. Carwell Gardner, legs churning, pounds it across the 45 to the 46-yard line. It'll bring up a third down for Buffalo, third and three.
Here's a moment now for the defense of the New England Patriots. As you see Thurman Thomas, they're still attending to him. Got a third down and three situation. If you can get the ball back for your offense right here, big moment.
Joe Montana with three touchdown passes in that Kansas City rout of Tampa. Kelly throws it for Reed, who comes back to get it. Finally covered on the play by Barnett. But Reed came back to catch the underthrow. It goes for 21 yards.
Darryl Wren had perfect coverage on the play. All over Reed, turns it up the field. An underthrown ball, the most difficult play for a defensive back because he can't find the ball. Andre Reed just making outstanding plays in the football game. He's been the difference thus far.
He's had some of his best games lifetime, including the best ever, as you pointed out, against New England. Davis. Kenneth Davis rips off 10 yards, 11 yards. Finally, Adrian White and others get him to the turf.
How'd you like to have a backup running back like Kenneth Davis? Was fifth in the Heisman balloting his senior year. He can play.
Gained over 600 yards as a backup to Thomas last season. That'll be the final play of the third quarter. At the end of three, Buffalo leading New England 17-14. We'll be back to Rich Stadium after these messages from your local station. Thurman Thomas back on the field for the Bills. First and 10 from the 22 of New England. Kelly for the end zone. Touchdown! Second of the day for Andre Reed.
You take Andre Reed out of this football game, and I'm not sure the Patriots aren't ahead at this point. Remember the play at the end of the first half? Again, the half roll, a little better position for Andre Reed. Boy, is he a football player.
He just beat Rod Smith that time. 22-yard touchdown reception, second of the day for Reed. Christie's extra point is through.
It's good.
And once again, the Buffalo Bills have knocked their lead back out to 10. 24-14, Buffalo. 25-yard touchdown drive have gone back up 10 on the New England Patriots. Christie will kick it off for Buffalo. As Jim Kelly threw his third touchdown pass of this opening week game. Kelly and Frank Reich is back up discussing that last turn of events. Brown and Crittenden deep for New England. That's a line drive kick taken by Crittenden. Crittenden, the former soccer player with a ton of speed, breaks it to the outside and is across the 30-yard line. Good return. Let's go back to that Kelly to Reed touchdown pass.
They came with a safety blitz coming right here, which forces this safety over to the middle of the field. One-on-one here, you're not going to win that battle against Andre Reed. Also, the roll away from the blitz, the perfect call for the Bills.
Tough play for Rod Smith, who hears it from Parcells as he comes off the field.
Hey, I tell you what, if I'm him, I'm saying you try to cover him, Coach.
They left him on the island, as it were, to cover Andre Reed, and there aren't many that can do that. Bledsoe tries to answer. Smith meets him at the pass.
Well, so much for the bad shoulder and the pulled hamstring. That time he got the inside track on Bruce Armstrong, made a nice move, and there's a few million dollars worth of pain.
An illustration, too, a very graphic illustration of why that left tackle is so important on your offensive line. It's the blind side of the quarterback, and that's where Smith collapsed on Bledsoe.
Can't give him the inside pass.
Russell can't quite turn the corner. Takes 5 or 6 yards close to the 30. Let's go to New York now, where Jim Lampley with an NFL Live update.
All right, Tom Hammond, so Keith Jackson mean a lot. As for the second time today in Indianapolis, Dan Marino finds Jackson down the middle of the Colt zone and snaps a 10-10 tie with that 27-yarder, 17-10 Miami now in the third. Back to Tom Hammond.
His ball, and boy, in retrospect, that Keith Jackson pickup for the Dolphins was huge a season ago.
You got it.
Bledsoe has the open man. Russell out of the backfield, fumbled the football, and Buffalo has it. Matt Darby recovers for the Bills as Russell coughs it up for the second time today. Two very costly fumbles by Leonard Russell.
He had the one that led to the Cornelius Bennett return, and now here again, Leonard Russell, 240 pounds a man. You can't let a defensive back strip the ball from you. What a good heads-up play to get right back on it. Matt Darby.
Matt Darby, the fifth-round draft choice in his second year out of UCLA. With a great defensive play, stripping the ball and then recovering it. Second turnover, both Leonard Russell fumbles. One Buffalo miscue has been a Jim Kelly interception.
Defense has to make a stand now, or you're looking at a blowout.
Thurman Thomas cuts up inside the 30 of the 28-yard line.
I just wonder if the Buffalo Bills may have come into this one thinking a little bit more about the Dallas Cowboys than they were the Patriots.
It'd be difficult not to, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
William Pachuski, please report to Southside Security.
They paid the price today, though. Some injuries on this Bills team. Maybe not that serious, but they're going to know they were in a game.
Two tight ends, Metzelaars and Ewalt. Gardner and Thomas in the backfield in the I formation, and Buffalo may try to work some clock here as Carwell Gardner bursts free. He's to the 20-yard line, and he may have a Buffalo first down. Drew Bledsoe saw his last drive sputter, wants the ball back, but it may be out of reach by the time he gets it back after that 8-yard run. Marv Levy can keep it on the ground, probably, and grind it out and work some clock.
The player down, and I can't tell who it is, but they're grabbing the knee, and that's never good.
We'll take a break with 12:41 left in the game and Buffalo leading New England by 10. Welcome back to Rich Stadium, where the injured New England player Brent Williams limps off the field, number 96.
He's the Patriots' fourth all-time leading sacker. Been a very durable player as well. Has started 79 of 80 games in his career. So we hope he's okay.
44 career sacks in his eighth year out of Toledo and is replaced by John Washington. Washington played 12 games for the Giants and 3 for the Falcons last year before being picked up by his old coach, Bill Parcells.
Yeah, and Bill Parcells has to be concerned. He is not very deep at all on that defensive line. He can ill afford to lose a Brent Williams.
12:39 left. The Bills looking to put it away now with a first down at the 20-yard line of New England. Thurman Thomas grabbed around the ankles, tackled after a gain of 2 with penalty markers down.
Flag on the play.
Maurice Hurst made the tackle, the shoestring job. As you see the scores, big debut for Joe Montana. Out with a sore wrist after he had thrown 3 touchdown passes. They can afford to let him go.
I saw Tampa Bay's defense during the exhibition season, and they're pretty tough.
Pittsburgh has come back on San Francisco a bit. Green Bay blowing out the Rams.
Wonder if Reggie White has any sacks.
Ditto Denver at New York. Tough day for Boomer.
Yeah, Denver really is an excellent team defensively. They're really underrated this year.
Miami and Indianapolis have been going at it all afternoon. Detroit with an easy lead over the Falcons.
Wonder about Jerry Glanville's job.
Thomas breaks free and then is just tripped up at the 19-yard line. Again, Maurice Hurst prevented the Thomas touchdown run.
And they went right at the spot vacated by Brent Williams. Just the counter tray. The House Ballard pulling around. Got a little hold in. Not bad. That was just one half a step away.
And Thurman Thomas over 100 yards rushing now on the afternoon. Here he is again. Dives forward to the 14, maybe the 13-yard line.
Well, now it's beginning to happen. You're seeing the machine that is the Buffalo Bills offense. A little less depth now because of the injury to Brent Williams. He now has six 100-yard games against the New England Patriots. Thurman Thomas does, and things are beginning to snowball for Bill Parcells and the Patriots.
Third down play. Kelly's going to pass for seven. Reed, number three of the day.
And Rod Smith may not want to go back to the sideline. Again, man-to-man coverage. They tried the blitz. Essentially, they had to. Look, they're sending the house here. That's man-to-man coverage. Reed gets the inside position. No way. No way.
Christie with the extra point attempt. And it is a seven-point Buffalo play to put the lead up to 31-14. Jim Kelly with four touchdown passes in the opener.
Boy, does he kill the Patriots.
And the kickoff, with the help of the wind, will sail out of the end zone. Well, before today, Reed had two career touchdowns versus the Patriots. He exceeded that in one fell swoop.
Here we go. They came with the all-out blitz. That forces linebacker coverage or safety coverage here. Man-to-man here. That leaves one-on-one on the outside. No way, ladies and gentlemen.
Today's attendance, 79,751.
Easy.
The Patriots and the Bills, thank you.
So Kelly to Reed has been a potent combination today. Look at the numbers on Jim Kelly. Brooks had a touchdown catch as well. So four scoring tosses by Jim Kelly today. Bledsoe in trouble. Got rid of it to Russell. Russell to the 22. Two Leonard Russell fumbles have led to two Buffalo touchdowns today. Jeff Wright made that tackle.
2 yard gain.
That's really been the difference. Remember in the first half, the New England Patriots were really on their first long drive of the day on that first fumble, and then Bennett scooped it up and went about 60 yards the other way. And then really the clincher, a fumble by Leonard Russell as well.
Get the idea that Jim Kelly may have gotten a little tired of hearing all about Drew Bledsoe. Four touchdown passes with 10 minutes still left. That one was ugly from the start. They never looked like they had any idea what was going on.
Well, you remember we told you that Bill Parcells said that get the call first.
Before the snap, the entire line moved. False start. 5 yards, it's still second down.
You think Parcells will take them all on now?
He could do it. Believe me, he could do it. Remember, I told you that. He said, well, I know I'm kind of throwing him to the wolves a little bit here, but if he can't handle one of those three interceptions, six sack, bleeding from the mouth kind of games, he's not the guy I thought he was. Get a chance to check his character after this one.
Well, the Patriots had some crucial mistakes today, but did show some flashes of competent football, if not brilliant. McMurtry with a short reception, chased back by Nate Odoms. Darrell Talley joins the fray, and McMurtry with a short reception. He had a touchdown pass reception earlier. There's Darrell Talley. He said he was underpaid and underappreciated. Looking forward to free agency. We echo those sentiments.
He's really been a good football player, though. 100-plus tackles for the last three seasons, two-time Pro Bowler. Very solid.
Third down play for Drew Bledsoe. Oh, he wasn't expecting the snap. Gets a good bounce and then will be taken. Now they'll mark it at the 1 yard line. No safety. They'll spot it just inside the one. Cornelius Bennett looked forward for another big play. He wanted the safety.
Bennett's out there putting on a show so far today. Had the fumble recovery. fumbled himself. Fumble recovery again. Now comes up with what has to be one of the most enjoyable hits of his career. Anytime you get to take a shot at a $1 million rookie, you just love it.
He gave the safety signal but didn't get the call. There's Biscuit. He went to Levy and asked to go back outside, and the coach said, we want you happy, so that's where he is. He'll punt from the end zone, and Saxon gets it away. Pretty nice boot. Taken by Copeland. Copeland bounces off a group of tacklers and goes to the other sideline, and goodbye. Copeland will go all the way.
Yesterday that of all his rookies, Russell Copeland seems the least in awe of playing in the NFL. What a great run. Have we seen some unbelievable plays today? Wow.
There have indeed been some big plays in this game, and Parcells blown out in his first game as New England coach, but the score will be a little misleading because for three quarters, New England was right in it. That was a 47-yard punt return for the touchdown by Copeland. The extra point is good, and with 8.5 minutes left in the game, the rout is on in Buffalo.
That this is not like the New England team of old. Emphasize the positive here, because they were toe-to-toe with the Buffalo Bills, the AFC champions, for a long time in this game, and it just got away at the end.
Kickoff down in the end zone. That punt return by Copeland, 47 yards for the touchdown, was the first Bills punt return for a TD since Ron Pitts way back in 1986.
And here will be a pretty good measure of whether or not the Patriots have managed an attitude adjustment under Bill Parcells. Want to watch to see if they come out with the same kind of intensity, still fighting, still scrapping, still doing the things you have to do to win football games, even though they're out of it now.
Bledsoe changing the call. Russell.
Bledsoe's pass,
6-yard gain as he goes out of bounds.
6-yard gain. That'll be
interesting as the Bills are on their way to 6 straight opening season wins under Marv Levy to talk about his philosophy in the preseason. Parcells, of course, with a young team, his first year as coach, wanted to get their attention, but Levy, a very laid-back coach in camp and in the preseason.
Yeah, but it's really worked for them. They have been the best team in football during the month of September, so you can't argue with his methods.
Intercepted. Picked off. James Williams with a shoot-top interception. First of Bledsoe's career. Tipped ball, and Williams picked it up off the turf.
And there you saw the speed coming into play of Marcus Patton, number 53, manned up in coverage, and he's just all over a very good tight end in Marv Cook. He's had his number all day. And then James Williams with the shoestring catch.
Cook has been a non-factor, and
the reason is Marcus Patton.
Patton has done a great job on him. And Frank Reich, number 14, is on to replace Jim Kelly, who threw 4 touchdown passes before leaving the game. There are the numbers on Reich a season ago, including, of course, the engineering of that tremendous comeback, the best in NFL history, as they beat the Oilers here in the playoffs. Nate Turner to the 25-yard line. Frank Reich started 6 regular season games in 8 years with the Buffalo Bills, and, of course, they were down 32 to Houston in the third quarter last season in the wild card game and wound up winning in overtime 41-38. Kelly's day is done. 4 TD passes.
Good day, too, by Jim Kelly. That comeback win engineered by Frank Reich was the greatest game I never saw. I turned it off at halftime, watched a basketball game.
Well, you weren't alone. A lot of the 80,000 fans here at Ridge Stadium left the game. Down 32 in the third. Who could blame them?
Nate Turner again.
The coaches of the Bills had a good line. They said everyone talks about Reich engineering that great comeback, but he got us in bad shape to start with.
He's the one that got us in that mess. But I know for Jim Kelly, this has been a good day for him. He wanted, he admitted before practice yesterday, he said, hey, last year was just an average year for me. All those interceptions weren't my fault. The coaches went back and looked, and about 10 or 11 of them were my fault. But he said, I'm looking for a much bigger year this year out of myself.
23 touchdown passes, 19 interceptions last season.
Nate Turner.
Turner to the 20-yard line.
They say Nate Turner was really the surprise of camp this year. He spent 92 on injured reserve with a bad back, but he's now come out and really had an outstanding preseason.
Turner, in fact, had such a good preseason that for a while the Bills tried Carwell Gardner at tight end. In fact, he lined up a tight end for a couple of plays today.
Yeah, and then he had one game where he had two fumbles and two dropped passes and blamed it on the fact that he had to play tight end. Not bad.
He's in there at the fullback spot now, is Gardner, with Davis at the tailback.
Fourth and one, they're going to go for it. A little salt in the wound.
Kenneth Davis bounces it to the outside and is drugged down in the backfield by Rene Thompson.
Now that's what you like if you're Bill Parcells. See that? Your team has stood up. They didn't just lay down and die. They make a big play there. They didn't allow him to get back in the end zone. A little heart shown by this Patriots defense.
Well, he knew Thompson was genuine from his days as a Giant.
Yeah, watch this play. Take on an offensive lineman, then bounce out and make a tackle, grabbing the back of the jersey. Rene Thompson has really been impressive today. Had the interception.
5:50 left in the game with Buffalo leading 38-14. Russell.
Leonard Russell.
Gains to the 30-yard line.
Bonnie Brown.
Looks like his endurance is holding up okay. Remember that Russell was stabbed in June just before training camp opened and lost a lot of blood, has had a lot of trouble with his endurance, but apparently he's going to make it four quarters in this one.
Chris, you wonder, too, about the Buffalo Bills, if there's any residual psychological damage from three Super Bowl losses. They all deny it, and kind of based on their play today, I think they might be right. Marv Levy was saying that players are able to put wins and for that losses and for that matter wins too behind them quicker than fans or media, and he thought they'd gotten over it.
And one, third and two.
And of course, they have a chance to avenge all three Super Bowl losses in the regular season starting next week.
Well, they've all gotten a little bit worse, it seems, though, especially that one last season. But I really believe that the Bills had a chance to win that Super Bowl if they put some points on the board early. At the end, it just turned into a blowout, though.
Well, as we said, as we started the telecast today, Leonard Russell has a New England first down. They've got the whole world rooting against them to go back a fourth time. What did Jay Leno say the other night? That the just taking turns on who will beat up on Buffalo this year. But Kelly and Reed said, we're going to make everybody mad and go back.
And they hear it all, too. They know. They're just kind of sticking it in their craw and using it for motivation.
Bledsoe with a little touch on that pass to Marv Cook. It'll be short of the first down. Gauganius and Bennett combining for the tackle for the Bills. How do you assess Drew Bledsoe's opening day performance?
Drew Bledsoe, I just think that he's looked like a rookie, to be honest with you. He hasn't had a lot of help around him. His receivers are not the strength of this football team. But he's gotten better as the days progress. He really came out nervous that first series, but seems to be much more comfortable in the football game now.
3.5 minutes left. We urge you to stay tuned for the post-game report here on NBC. Jim Lampley and company will bring you up to date on all the opening day action in the NFL.
Bledsoe's pass intended for Ben Coates.
Ben Coates, the intended receiver on that one. The Head and Shoulders post-game report coming up at the end of this Buffalo opening day victory, the Bills' sixth in a row.
Well, maybe the Green Bay Packers are going to be for real this season. A lot of question marks. They're going to be well over the salary cap, so they're going to have to make some changes in that football team for next year, but well, at least their debut, very impressive.
Bledsoe has been 14 of 27, 148 yards today, two touchdown passes. Leonard Russell. Parcells was telling us yesterday when the decision had to be made, Jim Kelly had a big day, four touchdown passes. When the decision had to be made, the Patriots had the number one choice, and everyone thought it would come down to a quarterback, either Rick Meyer of Notre Dame or Drew Bledsoe of Washington State. So what did Parcells do? He said he went to the film and looked at every pass that Bledsoe threw as a junior at Washington State and determined that there was no throw he couldn't make.
That's right, and said that one team offered him their entire draft for Drew Bledsoe.
He said when you have a chance to get a quarterback like that, though, it's an easy choice. That quarterback nearly had a tipped ball picked off again intended for Marv Cook, but it falls incomplete.
Matt Darby, who came up with a big strip earlier in the game and fumble recovery, again making a play. He's had a good ball game this afternoon. Daryl Talley back there as well, and Drew Bledsoe saying, so this is what the NFL's like.
You were saying yesterday that he has no idea. He may think he knows what it's going to be like, but you really have no idea, especially the speed things move in a regular season NFL game.
Yeah, you don't even recognize the veteran players in the locker room before the regular season opener as opposed to those preseason games.
Sam Gash dances forward for a yard or two. Lodish and Pike. A couple of words there with Pike to Gash at the bottom of the stack.
Mark Pike was a guy along with Mark Kelso that was placed on the waiver wire, and I think a lot of people were shocked and didn't really understand the move. But
well, that was confusing, wasn't it?
I don't know if the Bills would admit it or not, but I'm sure they had agreements with Mark Pike and Mark Kelso that they were going to come back before they put them out there on the wire so that they could protect some of those younger players.
There was all kinds of misinformation flying at that last cutdown and re-signing period. Incomplete pass as we come to the 1 second away from the two-minute warning intended for Timpson. It'll be fourth down for New England. So Drew Bledsoe takes over a quarterback spot that has been anything but sterling the last 3 years for New England.
Or stable. They've been running them in and out of there, but you can expect that list to end. Drew Bledsoe is going to be the guy now for many years to come.
Fourth down pass. Bledsoe zips it to the sideline over the head of the intended receiver, Greg McMurtry. And the clock will stop for the two-minute warning. 1:56 officially left of a Buffalo blowout. Bruce Smith with ice on that banged-up right shoulder. Already with a little hamstring pull and now a banged-up right shoulder as he heads to that rematch against the Cowboys next week. 38-14, the Bills take over on downs. You can likely close the book on Drew Bledsoe in his first game. 14 of 30, 148 yards, two touchdowns, and an interception.
Still find it hard to believe that Emmitt Smith is not signed and going to be playing for the Dallas Cowboys. To play the way that he has for that team and to not get the money that Thurman Thomas has gotten, it's just not justified.
Thomas with ice on an elbow, a banged up Buffalo team after this game against New England. He went over 114 yards rushing today.
Boy, did their stars come up big today. Thurman Thomas and Andre Reed and Jim Kelly, exactly the guys that Cornelius Bennett, Bruce Smith, exactly the guys that you need to play well, and they did.
The marquee names came to the fore. I'd thank our teammates, Kerry Haller and Larry Pollack on stats, our spotters Michael Gluck and Steve Solomon. And for Vic Frank, our producer, Joe Assetti, our director, Jeff Simon, Molly Solomon. It's been a good opening day game. Parcells' team showed flashes of being competitive. They were with the Buffalo Bills for three quarters before Buffalo blew it open in the final quarter behind four touchdown passes in the game for Jim Kelly.
But I think Bill Parcells wanted to see his team against the best. You know, get out there, face the best you have, and then you come back the next week and maybe it doesn't look quite as tough. He's a competitor, though. He's not enjoying it right now, I guarantee you.
So the clock will tick away the final seconds. Marv Levy has won six in a row. And Bill Parcells losing his debut as coach of the New England Patriots. Some measure of revenge for the Buffalo Bills, who saw Parcells beat them 20-19 in his last game as head coach of the New York Giants in Super Bowl 25.
Final score.
So after a slow start, the Buffalo Bills break open the game as Parcells' Patriots stay with the favored Bills for three quarters. The Buffalo finally wins it by a final score of 38-14.